I'm going to explain a Python code on Exploratory Data Analysis, shortly EDA. This is the Python code that I'm going to explain right away. We are in the kernel. So basically, I'm going to provide you the link in the description box of this video. Okay, let's start. First thing is we need to import the necessary libraries. We are going to import NumPy and Pandas. Obviously, we know NumPy is for numerical Python and Pandas for some sort of data processing. And for any sort of visualization, for this particular code, I am using matplotlib library. We will import the libraries here. So once I run here, execute highlighted code only. So from here, print os list directory input. In my Kaggle, I have this dataset. This dataset will be used in this particular code, basically in this particular video. Let me quickly go through the dataset. So this is a 47 by 13 column dataset. And from the data we can see, we have one value missing here, and maybe we have some other values missing as well. So in this line, it is showing me that I have this dataset associated with this particular kernel. So for this particular kernel, Exploratory Data Analysis, I have this dataset. See? So this dataset is printed. In this variable, I put all of the information from this particular CSV file. So this is the dataset. As we can see, here's the problem. We need to replace this one with something else, right? This is our dataset. Now, for example, for the final mark, let me go to the data. Final mark. I'm trying to understand the data, only the final mark. So maybe I am expecting to find out the minimum value, maximum value of this particular column. That can be done here. Data frame print. So if I run this one, it will give me the description of this particular column of the dataset. So from here, from the output, we can say for this particular column, this one, for this particular column, we have total record of 47. So 47 records. And the mean value, that means the average values of those data, is 62 point something. Then standard deviation, mean. So we have the idea of the data. Now that we have some problems in the data set, we need to solve those things. For example, we need to handle this thing. Enter first 2 digits of your roll number. So this is the Excel file, or this is the CSV file in my local computer. So this is the problem. See, we have some missing values as well. These are the missing values. We need to handle them. This is the text value that need to be replaced by some sort of integer values. So this sort of things must be done in data pre-processing step. So the location, I find out the location of that particular cell, this particular cell. So this is what? Fourth row and then some number of columns. So since Python is a zero based indexing language, I use 3 here. So this 3 is basically 4 in the dataset. And then for that particular cell, I replace it with 15. And then let me check the values here. So you can see that text value is replaced. Where is that? I guess this one. So that text value is replaced. Now performing EDA. We are going to draw 3 plots. Scatter plot, then box plot, and then histogram. So for scatter plot,
this is the x variable, that means the independent variable.
I'm trying to understand the relationship between attendance of the students to the final mark. In this cell, I call this column, and then for this column, I write this y value. After that, I draw the scatter plot, and then I need to show the scatter plot, right? So if I run this code, it will show me the scatter plot. Then I'm going to draw another scatter plot for class test mark versus the total mark. It is your class test mark, and this is your final mark. I'm just trying to find out if there is any relation. So if I run this particular code, I'll get another scatter plot. So in this scatter plot, I can say those who are getting more mark in the class test might get more mark in the final exam. That can be interpreted from this particular scatter diagram. Okay, let's move to the next plot, box plot. If I draw the box plot for the entire data set, let me just run this code. So if I plot the box plot, it will give me box plot for every column in the data set. So for every column, say for column B, C, for every column, I'm getting one box plot. And then let's draw the histogram. So this histogram is basically for the entire data set. You can see data frame 1. So it is for the entire data set.